What do a peregrine falcon with a broken wing and a red-tailed hawk with only one functional eye have in common? Both are birds of prey, and they're receiving much-needed medical attention at Saving Our Avian Resources, or SOAR. This tale is a journey of rehabilitation and reconnection with nature for both birds and humans alike. According to some experts, an eagle has around a 50-50 chance of surviving its first year of life in the wild. In the spring of 2013, it looked as if a pair of eaglets in central Iowa would be on the wrong side of that statistic. The nest they called home had been built in a dead tree in the shallows of a small lake. It is believed that high winds caused the tree to topple, putting both young birds in the water. Only one of the two eaglets survived the disaster, but was still in peril. It is difficult to see any animal in distress, but because an injured wild animal can still be dangerous, rescue should only be attempted by persons with training. As a retired conservation officer, John Mertz had been involved in many such situations.
So I kind of got to an upwind side of, there's a little bit of a breeze, and just drifted towards the log where the eagle was, without trying to use my paddle or anything. Tried to use a Carhartt to get on top of the bird, and he escaped. Did a little breaststroke to another log and got up on it. So I backed out of there, came into him again, and just went ahead and grabbed him by my hands.
It's preferable to leave a young animal in its home with its parents, but when the home has been destroyed, the question is, will the adults still be able to care for their babies? Even though the parents were still providing some food to the surviving eaglet, it was determined that the young raptor would perish if action wasn't taken.
It's really hard to tell, but it looks like we've got a small wing issue on the right wing. It's still a little bit hungry. You know, there's just an issue there with trauma, and it will have a better chance going with us today than it does staying here.
From its destroyed nest at Rock Creek State Park, the eaglet was transported 120 miles to what everyone hoped would only be a temporary home. Diversity Farms, which is south of Carroll, is the headquarters for SOAR, an acronym for Saving Our Avian Resources.
We're really not circumventing Mother Nature by trying to fix these guys. Usually what we see, the injuries are somehow human related. They're hit by car, they run into a window, they get tangled up in a barbed wire fence. And so 95% of the things that come in are related to some sort of human interaction.
While it's always the goal to return an animal to the wild, some injuries are so severe that a bird's only hope is to live the rest of its life in captivity. There are around 12 birds that have become permanent residents at SOAR. There's the snowy owl with a wing that didn't mend, the kestrel with a lack of fear after imprinting on humans, and an eagle blinded from lead poisoning.
Last year, 2012, we took in 49 bald eagles. If we were seeing 49 bald eagles, and they all had a random assortment of problems, broken leg, a poke in the eye, broken wing, you know, just a hodgepodge of things, I wouldn't be worried. But when 32 of those came to us because of ingested lead, then that's a problem.
Only 200 milligrams of lead, or a piece about the size of a grain of rice, can kill an eagle. Lead ulcerates the stomach, damages the kidney and liver, and will cause the brain to swell. In Thora's case, the swelling caused damage to the optic nerve, which has impaired her vision.
Poisoning is completely preventable. This is an easily prevented sort of thing that is happening. All we need to do is have hunters switch from lead ammunition to non-lead ammunition. They make non-toxic shot, copper bullets, copper slugs. Right now we have over 260 eagles in our database. Over 60% of those are there because of lead poisoning.
The facilities at SOAR include an intensive care area where birds are treated for their life-threatening injuries. The building is also divided into 17 flight pens where a bird can recover from its injuries and exercise its wings. For a young bird, it also provides an opportunity to learn social skills from older birds. Jasper, the young eaglet rescued from the lake when his nest was destroyed, suffered a deep muscle bruise. The 100-foot-long flight barn at SOAR was invaluable in helping the young eagle learn to fly as it recovered from its injuries. It took 3 months of rehabilitation before Jasper was ready for freedom. At a special event, he and 4 other birds from SOAR were released. The honor of returning Jasper to the wild went to John Mertz, the person who had rescued him.
The fun part of doing rehabilitation is to be able to give these guys a second chance at being wild. And it's fun to involve people. It's very exciting to be able to hold one. And you, when you're holding them, you can just kind of feel that it's like, I really want to go. I want to fly. And so for you to be able to let them go, it's just fun to be able to give them what they want and let them fly free.